No, this is not Windows Update, and yet it is, sort of. Adam Demasi, and I do hope I pronounced it correctly, aka HPCurb on Twitter, did a backport of legacy Windows Update to make it work again for old operating systems that Microsoft now considers defunct.
The question is, can I create a slipstreamed Windows 2000 professional CD containing most of the patches and include legacy update to .NET to facilitate future installs?
It's obsolete technology no one uses today, but I'll bring it back to life. I'm the Vintage Collector and these are my stories. So I've prepared here something already. I created a Slipstream folder containing both the Windows 2000 Professional CD ISO image and a patches directory into which I copied patchsets and service packs. More on that in an instant. So first I'm going to unpack the ISO image. It's best to use 7-zip here, but others capable of uncompressing an ISO image will work as well. Alternatively, if you have a CD-ROM, it's sufficient if you would create yourself a new folder where you just copy the entire contents of the Windows 2000 installation CD-ROM into. When inspecting the directory created by 7-zip, you'll notice this boot directory with the square brackets. This one contains the boot sector, which is important if you want to create the ISO file with another tool, such as CDBurner XP. To include legacyupdate.net's installer, I then create a folder called $OEM$. Inside this one, I create a subfolder C, and beneath that yet another one called legacyupdate. Into the latter, I'm going to copy the legacyupdate.net's installer. This special folder will later be automatically copied onto the drive C. Then I'll fire up nLite, which will help me to package everything up. You could also perform the slipstreaming using command line tools, though I prefer using nLite as this literally does all the work for you, sparing you a lot of mistakes. Here I choose the directory to which the Windows 2000 ISO was extracted to. nLite will show you some information about the version specifics of the image. From there, I go with the selection, which includes the service pack patches, unattended mode settings, and the creation of a new ISO file. Next, it's going to be about service packs. I'll include the service pack 4 installer, which will be extracted and integrated into the source files right away. Important is, just take the latest service pack, as these are always cumulative. Then I advance to the next screen for including additional patches. From here, you could integrate the update rollup, though I found something that replaces this. Cerebi.org offers a custom post service pack 4 package, which includes the majority of Windows 2000 updates up and until around 2010, including the said update rollup package. Beware though that this update package is targeted at the German release copy of Windows 2000 and won't work with any other language version. I didn't do any in-depth investigation on this behalf, but if you Google around for unofficial update packs for Windows 2000, you'll find something similar that may or may not work with nLite. Your mileage may vary. Meanwhile, I just double-check that the OEM pre-install option is enabled. On the localization tab, I'll then quickly change the default German language setting to use the Swiss German language, so I don't need to always do that myself during an installation. Other than that, I won't bother with any other settings. From here on, nLite will process all the options and assemble the files. It will also recompress everything, something that does not happen when you'd be slipstreaming the patches yourself via the CLI. Eventually, I get to choose to create an ISO file, which I'm calling Windows 2000 Professional SP4 Plus GER. Once the ISO file is finished, here you see how it grew only by about 20 megabytes as when compared to the original ISO file. From here, I'll then install Windows 2000. For better showing this with the screen recording, I'm using a VMware virtual machine here. Once Windows 2000 has finished the installation, I'm inspecting if the included legacy update.NET installer is there. And yes, it is. so I'm installing it quickly so I could start using it afterwards. I'll also briefly run the VMware tool setup so I can switch to a better screen resolution. And eventually, when searching for updates, legacy update will show me some missing stuff, mostly related to .NET and Windows Media Player, as literally everything else was already patched in by the slipstreaming process as shown before. And then, eventually, I will burn a real CD from that ISO image on my other Windows machine, because I have this other x86-based SGI machine, which needs some love. But then...
Of course, you could even include the .NET and Media Player setup files in the slipstream CD ISO image. Though, I wanted to show a method here which has most stuff in it, including the legacy update on .NET installer, so getting a vintage Windows 2000 up and running would be not as painful as before. And running just a few updates instead of almost 100 is no big deal after all. What troubles me though is that my SGI 230 bailed out. And, well, we're up to yet another repair. But that's a story for another time and another video. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if so, then please give me a thumbs up. For any comments or suggestions, you can always PM me directly on Twitter at VintageCollect, or also drop me comments on the community tab of this channel. Oh, and by the way, this channel has grown by 300% since August, and we're closing in for 400 subscribers. I know that's still small when compared to those huge channels with a million or so subscribers, but it makes me still proud, as obviously you people out there seem to be thirsty for retro topics. I owe you a big time thank you for being with me. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story. See you next time. If you check out this channel's community tab, you'll find some polls on potential upcoming videos. You're very welcome to upvote on upcoming topics or drop in new ones you'd like me to chase down.